As far as the human brain can easily understand it, we live in a four-dimensional world. In our everyday lives, we register length, width, height, and as we're contemplating these three planes, we do so through the function of time. But there are growing theories to say that actually it doesn't stop there. That really there are more dimensions beyond those that we know. And for one model at least, there could be, even should be, as many as 11. This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, what if humanity lives in 11 dimensions? Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. Do you ever feel the need to fundamentally question the physicality of your existence? Do you ever find yourself doubting the very fabric of reality itself? If so, then the extremes of theoretical science are certainly for you. We know that science, across all fields, is busy pushing the boundaries of what's possible in a bid to make new discoveries and breakthroughs. But in the furthest and most outlandish corners of scientific thought, the need for answers goes way, way deeper. String theory is arguably the most well-known attempt at the fabled theory of everything. As with all other theory of everything candidates, it tries to reconcile general relativity with quantum mechanics. And if it were found to do so, then we'd finally have one unified framework to explain all of life, the universe, and everything. Broadly, string theory suggests that reality at its tiniest, most basic level is comprised of one-dimensional vibrating strings. The nature of these strings' vibrations is then what governs how we understand subatomic particles and the differences between them, which is then how we know how to build the larger, wider world around us. Crucially, supporters argue that even gravity can be described via this model as the product of vibrating strings. And that's despite gravity being the key stumbling block for most other theory of everything claims. One of the most mind-bending aspects of string theory, however, is that it typically requires at least 10 dimensions to work. That is, 9 spatial dimensions and 1 time. This means that, for it to succeed, string theory needs length, width, and height, plus 6 others, plus time. Those 6 others are very difficult to visualize, although the first of them are usually presented by dividing reality up into membranes. In this way, the universe itself is a membrane, or brain, and its interactions with other brains, within another extra-dimensional space, is what really guides and shapes the way things are. Unsurprisingly, however, with such a vast and complex reimagining of the world to work within, not every version of string theory is identical. After it was first proposed in general in the 1960s, various models were developed in a race to fill in the details. So much so that by the mid-1990s, there were 5 leading models at least. But then came M-theory, which appeared to unify all other string theories before it. Although in doing so, it added yet another dimension onto the pile. M-theory posits that there are actually 11 dimensions in total, 10 spatial and 1 time. The US mathematician and physicist Edward Witten is held to be the father of M-theory. Its history traces back to one particular conference at the University of Southern California in 1995, where Witten delivered a then-paradigm-shifting talk to his peers, in which he linked all previous string theories into one. The meaning as to the M in M theory is somewhat unclear, although Witten himself is said to have suggested either magic, mystery, or membrane for the unknown initial. In practical terms, membrane perhaps makes the most sense, again given how the theory relies on the manipulation of membranes to shape existence. But if there is room for romance in the realm of theoretical science, then perhaps magic is closer to the point. Because to the everyday mind that isn't constantly involved in considering the fundamental nature of the universe, that's arguably what M-theory amounts to – magic. To even begin to grasp it, you must look beyond everything you've ever known. Everything that currently surrounds you, including your body itself, no longer has just length, width, and height. But instead, it is fashioned into existence through the multifaceted brain world prism that, so the theory goes, is actually all around us. Indeed, that prism is what we are. It may then feel like we walk on the ground in a 3D landscape. But actually, it's more like we're floating in a 5D vat across a 7D plane with a 9D perspective, and so on. Given the standard string theories that preceded M-theory, arguably one way of viewing it is as though we and everything else are held together and in place like puppets on the stage, driven and directed by unseen forces that are wholly beyond our control. Yes, we still see only our 3D surroundings, but there's so much more that we don't see, holding it all together, as though backstage. Importantly, at present, M-theory isn't a proven concept, and for many leading scientists, it isn't physically credible. For those against, while we know that our theories on general relativity and quantum mechanics remain incomplete, string and M-theory still isn't the answer. Certainly, one difficulty with string theory and M is that it's very hard to reliably test from our lowly 3D plus time position. But what do you think? Can you picture reality as nothing more than a massive bunch of 1D strings vibrating themselves into life and variety? Or is the idea simply more fantasy than fact? Let us know in the comments. But finally, and nevertheless, what if M-theory is correct, and therefore humanity does live in 11 dimensions? What then? On the face of it, of course, not a great deal would change. If those 11 dimensions have always been there, and it's just that we're only now beginning to understand that, then clearly the universe has always been dependent on that framework and would therefore continue to be. Physically speaking, nothing would happen except everything would carry on as it always has done. On a personal human level, though, the revelation would be huge. For one, it would confirm that there are other universes out there, that there have always been other realities alongside our own, with them most easily envisioned as existing on or along similar membranes to the one that we apparently occupy. But it's not as though the confirmation of M-theory would suddenly allow us to access them. We'd still be a long way from that, with it perhaps being an impossible feat. Consider how tricky an issue the relatively simple concept of time remains for us today. We know that time is there, and important, and to some degree we can describe and manipulate it, but still, time controls us far more than we control it. Uncover a 5th, 6th, 7th dimension, and more? And that knowledge on its own would similarly not count for much. We would still be wholly at the mercy of whatever those extra dimensions dictated. And yet, as M-theory brings the multiverse into view, it does also open up the possibility of higher dimensional beings. Beings that do have a full grasp of time, and that can physically view the world in more than length, width, and height. Those creatures would then be so far removed from us that we would probably fail to recognize them. To some degree, this would be Carl Sagan's famous Flatland demonstration to explain time itself, only with 7 or more further chapters. Considering all those extra dimensions too, could it mean a kind of hierarchy of physical being, with some making it to 6D, some to 8D, 10D, and so on? At every level, presumably, there'd be an unknowable level above. Unless, of course, you're a being at the very top, in M-theory at the 11th dimension, in which case there'd be no further for you to go. If there is a god, then maybe this is it. Although, would that being also be aware that there was nothing else above them? If yes, then could they be wrong? If no, then do they really have omniscience? Those are questions for another video. For now, we have something of a choice as members of humankind. Do we accept 3D reality plus time as being the limits of our existence, as being all there is? Or do we look to break that universal mold in search of something more, and in a bid to answer some of life's biggest unanswered questions? It started with general relativity, then along came quantum mechanics, and the race to a theory of everything has been on ever since. And if M-theory were found to be the unifying model, then that's what would happen if humanity lived in 11 dimensions. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.